Bill Gates, Beyonce, Oprah, the Infographic Show. For years, rumors have swirled that powerful organizations and celebrities have all been part of a global movement to control humanity and shape the way it thinks. In most cases, this movement takes the form of the infamous Illuminati, a group allegedly dedicated to absolute control over all mankind. But who actually are the Illuminati? What do they really want? And how do you know this video itself is not just more Illuminati propaganda meant to throw you off the scent from the truth? The name Illuminati actually comes from the Latin plural illuminatus, or enlightened. The name is inspired by the idea of enlightening oneself through knowledge, and would evolve to signify the breaking of a man's bonds of ignorance through education and reason. But it all started with one man who really, really hated his bosses. Adam Weishaupt was born in 1748, and in 1773 he gained employment at the University of Ingolstadt as a professor of canon law. Basically, the laws that governed cannons both on a battlefield and on ships. Okay, fine, actually, canon law is the guidelines and regulations which are established by a religious authority for the purpose of running a government of a religious organization. In essence, Weishaupt was an expert on church law, but was himself not actually a member of the clergy. This would be a bit of a problem in a university which was mostly run by clergy, and not just any clergy, but Jesuits. Jesuits were themselves established in the 16th century with the approval of Pope Paul III. Their official mission was global evangelization with a special focus in education and helping different sects of Christians to work together. Jesuits were sort of the SEAL Team 6 of Christianity, and were told to expect to go anywhere in the world and suffer any adversity for the sake of helping the poor and uneducated. Jesuits, however, soon became a thorn in the side of the European powers, as they were a little too good at their job. Jesuits established special settlements in many colonial territories and refused to allow the populations under their care to be enslaved as local governments and businessmen wished to. With slave labor being critical to the economies of far-flung colonies, Jesuits very quickly got a bad rap for standing in the way of economic progress. It should be noted that Jesuits weren't completely opposed to slavery. You have to remember that this was a time when slavery was a widespread and accepted practice. White Europeans themselves had been enslaved just several hundred years earlier. Jesuits were, however, opposed to the brutal conditions slaves endured, seeing no need for slaves to be treated like animals. Nothing.